Hello, EXHIBE FLIX again! Before we start, we invite you to visit us at exhibeflix.com, our own channel, to watch great movies and follow us on Facebook and Instagram. Today we will talk about 20th century wars in film. 55 Days at Peking, a movie from 1963, England, about the 1900 Boxer Rebellion against foreigners in China, with Charlton Heston, Ava Gardner, and David Niven. Bricker Morant, a movie from 1980, Australia, about the Boer War. Three Australian lieutenants are court-martialed for executing prisoners as a way of deflecting attention from war crimes committed by their superior officers. Directed by Bruce Beresford with Edward Woodward. General Luna, an American movie from 2015, about a historical aspect we don't know much about, the Philippine-American War, where a short-tempered Filipino general faces an enemy more formidable than the American army, his own treacherous countrymen. Directed by Gerald Tarrug. This American movie depicts the bloody siege of the fortress Port Arthur during the Russo-Japanese War of 1904 to 1905. A very interesting fact, this was the first major military victory in the modern era of an Asian power over a European one, in this case the Russians. And the movie stars beloved actor Toshiro Mifune. Did you know that Pancho Villa, the famed figure from the Mexican Revolution, and with many fans on both sides of the border, made a deal with Hollywood to film his war and recreate his life? That movie was, and starring Pancho Villa himself in 2003, with Antonio Banderas. 1911 from 2008, it's a movie from China about the Xinhai Revolution. It's a historical drama based on the founding of the Republic of China, where nationalist forces led by Sun Yat-sen overthrew the Qing Dynasty. Now, who do you know is a famous Chinese actor and stunt person? Jackie Chan. Jackie Chan directed and stars in this movie, making his own stunts. In this West German movie directed by Stanley Kubrick, after refusing to attack an enemy position, a general accuses the soldiers of cowardice, and their commanding officer must defend them. Now, the movie stars Kirk Douglas, but did you know Charlton Heston turned down the role of Colonel Dax in order to star in Orson Welles' Touch of Evil? This is a Russian 2008 biopic about Alexander Kolchak, a vice admiral in the Imperial Russian Navy and leader of the anti-communist white movement during the Russian Civil War. Actress Elizaveta Boryaskaya, after being asked about the film Dr. Zhivago, stated, "The only thing that these two films share consists in the love in which the Russian women can carry. They love up to their last drop of blood." Kurtuluş from 1994 is a Greco-Turkish war television series from Turkey. It was first released in 1994 about the War of Independence, the end of the Battle of Hunuhnu in April 1921, and the Mundani Armistice in October 1922, describing the end of the approximately 1.5-year conflict. Michael Collins is Neil Jordan's historical biopic of Irish revolutionary Michael Collins, the man who led guerrilla war against the UK, helped negotiate the creation of the Irish Free State, and led the National Army during the Irish Civil War, starring Liam Neeson and Julia Roberts. This movie is also known as the beginning of the Great Revival, and it chronicles the events that led to the founding of the Chinese Communist Party, and it marks the 90th anniversary of the Communist Party of China. Now, the directors are Snap Han and Jihan Huang, and it features an all-star cast. Guess who? John Woo, the famed director. This is a movie from Belgium at the outbreak of the Spanish Civil War, where the nun Maria is forced to flee her convent. She takes refuge in a brothel until it is liberated by a woman's anarchist group. Maria joins the group and eventually goes to the front. This is directed by Vicente Arend and starring the beloved by Spain actress and singer Ana Belén. This movie is about a general sentiment among anti-Japanese resistance forces that the Communist Party of China was not contributing enough to the war, and that they were only interested in expanding their power. As a result, the CCP planned a major offensive against the Japanese consisting of 105 regiments called the 100 Regiments Offensive, The Longest Day is a 1962 epic war film based on Cornelius Ryan's 1959 book, The Longest Day, about the D-Day landings at Normandy on June 6, 1944, during World War II. The film was produced by Daryl F. Zanuck, who paid author Ryan $175,000 for the film right. The events told on a grand scale from both the Allied and German points of view feature an incredibly long list of name actors like Sean Connery, John Wayne, and many more. This movie, directed by Zhejiang Feng Assembly from China, is about a soldier who fights to gain recognition for comrades who died during the Chinese Civil War. The film, ostensibly portraying an anti-war theme, was first released on 20 of December 2007. It won the 2008 100 Flowers Awards and the 2009 Golden Rooster Awards for Best Film. The movie is also known as November 10th. Musa, a 13-year-old shoeshiner, whom along with her friend Yuma, undergo destiny through their adventure of waging war during the Indonesian National Revolution and their possibility of bringing peace among the troops that keep on fighting for nothing. The story takes place during the Greek Civil War. Two brothers from Greek countryside find themselves to fight with the two opposite sides. Gradually, the two boys are fanaticized and become crueler by war conditions. The film shows the hard condition of battlefields as well as the impact of the war on civilians. Starring Donald Pleasence as an American reporter finding himself in the middle of the 57-day Battle of Dien Bien Phu in Vietnam between the French army and the Viet Minh, which finally resulted in the defeat of surrender of the French forces and France's eventual withdrawal from Vietnam. The film was nominated for Best Music Written for a Film at the 1993 French César Awards. This South Korean movie, two brothers are forced to fight in the Korean War, and the elder decides to take the riskiest missions if he will help shield the younger from battle. The film became one of the biggest successes in the South Korean film history up to that time, attracted 11.75 million people to the theater. Intimate Enemies is a French drama that follows a French platoon during Algeria's War of Independence. As part of production information, the crew spent nearly 2 months scouting locations in Morocco, and also the film was fully storyboarded before shooting. This is a movie directed by Randall Wallace with Mel Gibson, Marilyn Stowe, Greg Kinnear, John Hamm, and it's about the first battle of the Vietnam War. Actually, in the movie, the real Joseph Galloway was invited to see the movie, and he stepped out of the movie theater saying, "That was my nightmare for 36 years. I don't want to see it again." The movie is about the Congo crisis in the 1960s. The old, hard to come by, but historically accurate Gustav machine guns, seen, used by the movie's actors, were procured in South Africa. By checking the serial numbers, it was confirmed that some were the very same guns used in the conflict. In this movie, Cambodian author and human rights activist Long Ung recounts the horrors she suffered as a child under the rule of the deadly Khmer Rouge. Actually, director, co-writer and producer Angelina Jolie has had Cambodian citizenship since 2005, and her adopted son Maddox was born there. Border. In this 1971 movie, along the border region of Longwela, a small battalion of Indian soldiers go up against a 2,000 well-armed Pakistani strike force. J.P. Duda's brother was an Indian Air Force pilot who died in a MiG crash in 1987. The film is dedicated to him. Kippur, that was a movie made in 2000, was about the attack from Egypt to Israel in 1973. This movie actually is not a traditional blood, guts, and glory film. It's basically following the rescue crew trying to pick up the pieces. It was directed by Amos Gitai. In this movie, director Ali Folman is interviewing people that fought along him in the 92 invasion of Lebanon. He interviews people to reconstruct the story in an animated feature. Actually, this is the first animated film to be nominated for Best Foreign Language Film Oscar, and it took 4 years to complete. This movie is about the Sino-Vietnamese War and its conflict influencing China in the 1970s. It's about how it influences the youth at that time, including Xiaoping in our movie, who joins the military, and it changes his dreams forever. Latino was directed by the cinematographer Haskell Wexler, and it was set in the context of the Sandinistas in Nicaragua. Basically, it is when the US-backed Contra rebels were supported by the United States. In the particular movie with Robert Beltran and Tony Plana, Beltran plays a Vietnam War training Contras. This is a movie where young Soviet Army recruits are stuck in the bloody war in Afghanistan that was started by politicians, and 2,000 extras were used in battle scenes. This movie was very important, and the director dedicated this movie to his father. Very nice one indeed. An Iranian historical TV series that narrates the Iranian history in a 60-year period from jungle movement to Iranian revolution and Iraq-Iran war. It spans the period of history between the revolutionary movement to the freedom of Khorramshahr during the 8-year war between Iran and Iraq in the 1980s. The story is told through the trials and tribulations, love and relationships of one family. The series runs for 52 episodes. Innocent Voices was directed by Luis Mandoki, starring Leonor Varela and Ofelia Medina. And it's about a little boy caught in the middle of the war in El Salvador and in a fight for his life. This was the official submission from Mexico for the 77th Academy Awards. And he got really a lot of awards and did really well with the critics. Death by Fire is a story of two young men who were sent to fight the 1982 war in the Falkland Islands in Argentina, and who return home bearing the brutal scars of war. It is based on a book written by a veteran of the war, and the film was nominated for 22 awards and won 14 of them, directed by Tristan Bauer. And it deals with the emotional and all the different aspects that a war in Argentina brought on in 1982. As we end our report about movies about war, we leave you with the Madras Cafe scenes there that lead to deal with the Indian intervention in the Sri Lankan War and the assassination of former Indian Prime Minister Rajiv Gandhi. Thank you for watching! What is your favorite war film from our report? And what other topics would you like us to analyze? Have you subscribed to this channel? Ring the bell to be notified of new videos. Share our content. Like us. Also follow us on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. And what are you waiting for? Visit us at EXHIBEFLIX.com for great movies, and follow other film lovers.